Hi there, Ms. Barber here. This lesson is titled Negations of Conditional Statements and De Morgan's Laws. Let's begin with a definition. The negation of if P, then Q is P and not Q. Say that with me. The negation of if P, then Q is P and not Q. Symbolically, we write the negation symbol, open parentheses, P, right arrow, Q, close parentheses, looks like an equal symbol but with three bars, P and squiggly Q. Example, construct and write the negation of the statement, if I am in Houston, then I'm in Texas. Part A, assign simple statements to P and Q. Let's begin with, I'll let P be I am in Houston, and let Q be I am in Texas. Part B, construct both the statement and the negation of the statement symbolically. I'll begin with a statement, which would be, if P, then Q. Now we need the negation of that symbolic statement, that is the negation of P implies Q. We just learned that definition, that is P and not Q. Now using those symbols, we're gonna go to part C and write the negation in words of the statement. So we would have for P, I am in Houston and I am not in Texas. De Morgan's Laws, Law 1. The negation of the conjunction P and Q is not P or not Q, and the negation of the disjunction P or Q is not P and not Q. Example, write the negation of each of the following statements. Part A, I study or I do not pass. Let's put these symbolically, so I'm going to let P be I study, and Q be I pass. Now let's express I study or I do not pass symbolically. That would be P or not Q. What we want is the negation, which would be not P or not Q. And De Morgan's Laws tells us that the negation, not P or not Q in parentheses, is equal to not P and not Q. Let's clean that up a little bit. That would be not P and Q, because not Q takes us back to P. Now let's put these back in words. If P is I study, squiggly P would be I do not study. So I do not study and I passed anyway. Part B, I have a meaningful job and I volunteer at the local community center. Again, let's assign symbols to those. So I'm going to let P be I have a meaningful job and Q be I volunteer at a local community center. Let's put that English statement, I have a meaningful job and I volunteer at a local community center, into a symbolic statement. So that would be P and Q. We want the negation of P and Q, so we want not, and then in parentheses P and Q. De Morgan's Laws tells us that to negate that compound statement of P and Q, that is equal to not P or not Q. Let's use that to write the negation in words. We would have, I do not have a meaningful job, or I do not volunteer at a community center. Part C, if I pay my bills on time and my debt to income ratio is appropriate, then I have a good credit score. We've got three simple statements here. Let's go ahead and assign variables to them. I'm gonna let P be, I pay my bills on time. Then Q will be, my debt to income ratio is appropriate. And finally, I'm gonna let R be, I have a good credit score. So let's take that English statement, and express it symbolically. If P and Q, then R. We got to negate that. The negation of A implies P is A and not B. A is our P and Q together. B is the R. Let's apply it. P and Q and not R. Now let's put some words in its place. I pay my bills on time and my debt to income ratio is appropriate and I still do not have a good credit score. Example, construct the negation of each of the following statements. Notice that this time we have no words. We'll start with A. P implies, and in parentheses, not R and S. We want to negate P implies, and in parentheses, not R and S. To do that, we're going to use the definition, that is, the negation of A implies B. Well, that's equal to A and not B. We're going to apply that P and not, and then in parentheses, not R and S. Now we're going to have to use De Morgan's laws for the second part, and the negation of A and B in parentheses is not A or not B. We will apply that to the second part of not, and then in parentheses, not R and S, which will give us P and R or not S. Let's look at part B. P and then in parentheses, R implies not S. We want to negate that, so we'll put the negation symbol in front of, and then in parentheses, P and, open parentheses again, R implies not S, close parentheses, close parentheses. And we'll use De Morgan's laws, not, and in parentheses, A and B, that is not A or not B. Let's apply that to our statement, and we will get not P or not, and then in parentheses, R, right arrow, squiggly, S. Let's continue for the second part, the squiggly, that's the not, and in the parentheses, if R, then not S. We'll use the definition that lets us negate an if-then statement. The negation of if A then B is A and not B. We'll apply that and you get not P or R and not S. Let's simplify the double negation and we will finally have not P or R and S. Example. Determine which, if any, of the three given statements are equivalencies. A, if it is hot, then I use the air conditioner. Let's assign them letters. I'm going to let P be, it is hot. Then I'll let Q be, I use the air conditioner. Now let's express A in symbolic form. It's if, then, so it'll be P, right arrow, Q. Let's look at part B. If I do not use the air conditioner, then it is not hot. That would be not Q implies not P. Part C. It is hot and I use the air conditioner. Symbolically, that would be P and Q. Any of these equivalent? Statements A and B are equivalent because they are contrapositives. However, statement C is not equivalent. Check with a truth table.